If you're on the road and you need to access resources in your home network, the absolute best way to do that is with a VPN. And that can be made even easier with the router solutions from GL.iNet, who are the sponsor of this video. Now, I've been using GL.iNet travel routers for ages, well before they were a sponsor. They're super easy to use and much more secure than connecting your devices to a public wireless network directly when you're on the road. I have a full non-sponsored video on exactly how I use my own Barrel AX travel router that I'll link to down in the description below. But in this video, we're gonna do a 1-2 punch. I'm gonna show you a home router and a travel router VPN combo that you can set up in minutes to provide secure communication with your home network when you're on the road. We'll start by setting up the Flint 2 Wi-Fi 6 router as your home device. I'll go through some basic settings that all home users should consider, and then we're gonna set it up as a VPN server and use the Slate AX travel router as a VPN client that can connect to your Flint 2 when you're on the road. We're gonna do that entire setup from start to finish, and I cannot stress enough how easy this is to do. All right, let's get started. Here's the overview of what I'm going to build today. On the left-hand side, I have the Flint 2 home router connected with a static IP address to my Comcast business internet connection. Inside that LAN is a Mac Mini M2 running open speed test. On the right-hand side, we're simulating our hotel or remote connection. To simulate a hotel internet connection, I'm using T-Mobile Home Internet, which has a CGNAT IP address connected to the WAN port of the Slate AX travel router. I'll have my laptop connected to the Slate AX over wireless, and at the end of the video, I'll be able to demonstrate connecting from my laptop to the Slate AX through a VPN tunnel to the Flint 2, and then to open speed test running on this Mac Mini inside my LAN. The Flint 2 is a Wi-Fi 6 home router with two 2.5 gigabit Ethernet ports. One is for WAN, and the other is a combo WAN LAN port. It also has 4 additional 1 gigabit LAN ports for wired connectivity. The Flint 2 is on sale for $127 through June 15th with coupon code 20MT6000 or by clicking the link down in the description. This Flint 2 is in a factory default state, so let's go ahead and get started with the configuration. Okay, so I plugged my internet connection into the WAN port of the Flint 2, and I have plugged my laptop into one of the LAN ports of the Flint 2. Now, by default, there is a DHCP server enabled in the Flint 2 router, which means that my laptop automatically received an IP address in the 192.168.8.x network. So it's 192.168.8.0/24 in CIDR format. The next thing I did is open up a browser, and I point that browser to the IP address of the Flint 2, which is 192.168.8.1. And that brings us to the initial setup wizard. So here I'm just gonna choose my language as English, and I'm going to set an admin password for the Flint 2 device. Okay, password has been set, and we are now logged into the Flint 2. The first thing we want to do is come over here to System, where we see a little warning, and that warning is telling us that our time zone has not been set yet. So let's go to Time Zone, and I'm just going to start typing Los Angeles since I am in US Pacific time, and we're going to apply, and that'll get rid of that little error. Next, I'm going to set a static IP address on this device. Now, I have a Comcast business connection with 5 static IP addresses, so I'm going to use one of those static IP addresses directly on the Flint 2, but you may be able to skip this step if your internet connection provides you your IP address automatically, or what's known as dynamically. Okay, so you might not have to do this next step. I'm only doing it because I actually have a static IP address that I can use. So I'm gonna click on Internet, and then under Ethernet 1 here, I'm gonna say Modify. We're gonna set it to Static, and then I'm gonna enter in my static IP address information and hit Apply. Okay, so that setting is done, and now if you have a dynamic IP address and you're going to be using this device as a VPN server, that dynamic IP address might change from time to time. So that can affect the VPN server that you're setting up. So what you would want to do in that case is set up what's called a DDNS or dynamic DNS name. Luckily, GL.iNet makes that super, super easy. We can click on Applications and then Dynamic DNS, and then all we need to do is enable our Dynamic DNS hostname, agree to the terms, and click Apply. And now that hostname that you see here can be used to directly connect to your home router, regardless of what the IP address might change to. All right, so we have our LAN set up, we have our WAN set up. Let's go ahead and now add a wireless network. So I'm gonna click on Wireless, and we can see here that we have 5 GHz Wi-Fi, 5 GHz guest Wi-Fi, which is disabled by default. And then if we scroll down, we have 2.4 GHz Wi-Fi and 2.4 GHz guest Wi-Fi. So the first thing I'm gonna do is change the 5 GHz Wi-Fi settings. So we'll say modify, and I'm gonna call this Flint 2 5G. Then we're gonna set a strong Wi-Fi password and click apply. Scrolling down, I'm gonna do the same thing to the 2.4 GHz network. We're gonna say modify, and I'm gonna call it Flint 2 2G. It's actually 2.4 GHz, but we'll just call it 2G, and then set a strong Wi-Fi password and click apply. So now I have the 5 GHz and 2.4 GHz wireless networks configured and enabled. They've set passwords on them. I could also enable guest Wi-Fi if I want guests to come over, you know, use a different password for that one so that they're not on your secure network. But for the purposes of this demo, I'm gonna leave the guest network disabled. Another thing that you might wanna do for home use, however, is enable AdGuard Home. And this is a network-wide ad and malware blocker. So let's go over to Applications, AdGuard Home. And then we're just gonna turn that on. And we also wanna allow our clients to use AdGuard Home, so we're gonna turn that on as well, and we're gonna click Apply. And now notice that a bunch of statistics have popped up down at the bottom. Those statistics don't have any data yet, but over time, that will start to populate with how many ads have been blocked and how many malware settings have been blocked. Now we can see that DNS queries are actually already starting to populate in AdGuard Home. All right, the next thing we wanna do is let's go back to our LAN settings and just take a look at our DHCP server and how that is set up. So we're gonna go to Network and LAN. And here we can see that the default is a Class C or /24 network at 255.255.255.0, and that's 192.168.8.x. Now, if you scroll down though, look at the DHCP server. So it has a DHC pool size, so this is the addresses that are available to hand out to client devices that connect either wired or wirelessly to this network, and it's giving us between 100 and 249. Now that's kind of small considering that most of our devices are probably going to be dynamically assigned. So I'm going to change this to 10. I'll give myself, you know, 10 static IP addresses, and then we're going to max out the top at 254. Now, if you click on Advanced, you can also add different DNS servers that are handed out to your clients. So for instance, if you're using your own ad blocker like Pi-hole, or if you're using some online service or just a, you know, your ISP's DNS, this is where you would put in that information. But I'm gonna leave it default for the purposes of this video. Okay, so now we've basically set up our entire network. We did wireless, we got LAN, WAN, everything set up and good to go. So now let's create our VPN server. To do that, we're gonna click on VPN. If we click on the VPN dashboard, we can see that right now nothing is set up. All of these things are gray, so we have no VPN client, we have no VPN server. We're gonna do a WireGuard VPN server. Now you can do either OpenVPN or WireGuard, but WireGuard is sort of the newer, faster protocol for VPN, so we're gonna do WireGuard, and I'm just gonna say set up now. We're gonna click generate configuration. So what this is telling us here is that the IP address for the VPN network that the Flint 2 is creating is 10.0.0.1/24. That is perfectly fine for our uses, so we're just gonna say start. Okay, so we have started our VPN server. We're done, basically. There's actually one more setting. So if I go back to the VPN dashboard, notice now that we have WireGuard enabled. Currently there's no clients, but I have settings over here. So I'm gonna say settings. And then right here, this first setting says remote access to LAN. Now remember, one of the things that we wanna do is connect to our open speed test server that's running on this Mac Mini that's connected to the LAN port of the Flint 2, or one of the LAN ports of the Flint 2. If I leave this setting off, VPN clients can talk to each other in that 10.0.0.x network, but they don't have access to something on my LAN, such as the interface of the Flint 2 or OpenSpeedTest. So we're gonna enable that so that remote VPN clients that connect in have access to our internal LAN resources. Okay, so let's say apply. And for good measure, I'm just gonna turn it off and turn it back on to make sure that that setting takes. And now the last thing we need to do is tell the Flint 2 to generate a client configuration that we're gonna put on the travel router, right? So that the travel router has all of the information that it needs to connect over to the Flint 2 when we're working out of a hotel room. And right now, remember, I'm simulating a hotel room with a completely separate internet connection, right? This is T-Mobile home internet versus the Flint 2, which is running on my Comcast business connection. So I'm gonna click on WireGuard server, and then I'm gonna click on profiles, and we're gonna add a new profile. Now, best practice says you should have a separate profile for each different client that's gonna connect, whether that client is a laptop just running WireGuard, and you know, the application WireGuard on it, or if it's a router such as this Slate AX. So we're just gonna call this Slate AX for the client configuration, and we're gonna say apply. Now, when we say apply, we get this pop-up right here. Now this has a QR code. Now I could scan that QR code and then WireGuard can read the QR code and automatically configure, or I can download the configuration file, which is actually what I'm gonna do. But notice this setting up here. Use DDNS domain. So remember earlier, when I set a static IP address on the Flint 2, I told you if you don't have a static IP address, it's a good idea to enable dynamic DNS, right? So that even if your IP address changes, the IP address that you get from your ISP, even if that IP address changes, you still have that fully qualified domain name that is always updated with the latest IP address. Well, this setting is telling WireGuard, hey, don't use the direct IP address to connect in, use that dynamic DNS name. So if you have a dynamic internet connection, you're gonna wanna flip that on. In my case, I have a static, I know my IP address is not gonna change, so I'm gonna leave that disabled. But I'm gonna click download, and that is going to download a copy of the WireGuard VPN client configuration, and then I'm gonna eventually upload that same file over here on the Slate AX. That's what we're gonna do next. The Slate AX travel router features the same OpenWRT-based operating system as the Flint 2, but it has a much smaller form factor. This router has 1 gigabit WAN port and 2 gigabit LAN ports for your wired devices, and of course, it also has Wi-Fi 6 for your wireless clients. One of the best reasons for using a travel router is so that all of your family's wireless devices don't have to be reconfigured every time you go to a new hotel room. You can set them up once to connect to the Slate AX, and then when you get to the hotel room, you simply plug in the travel router, connect it to the internet, and then all of your devices are automatically connected. All right, so let's get this thing set up. I'm going to pull my laptop connection from the Flint 2 and I'm going to plug it into the Slate AX. Now the Slate AX starts off with the same exact default IP address, so my laptop should be able to connect to it pretty easily. And here we go. So by browsing to 192.168.8.1, I can see the initial setup wizard. We're gonna go through the same process. We're gonna say next, give it a strong admin password and hit apply. And now that we're in the dashboard, I can see that the internet is already trying to connect. The T-Mobile home internet gateway is gonna give the WAN port of the Slate AX a 192.168.12.x IP address. I can see that that is what it has received, and very shortly it should actually connect to the internet, no problem. In the meantime, however, we have that same warning about the time zone, so let's go set our time zone. We're gonna say system, time zone, Los Angeles, and apply. All right, that warning is now gone. And since this has the same LAN subnet, 192.168.8.x, as the Flint 2, and we want to be able to route from devices in this network to devices in the Flint 2 network, we're going to have to change the LAN subnet of the Slate AX. So let's do that first. I'm gonna click on network and then LAN, and right here where it says router IP address, I'm just gonna change this to 10.1, right? It could be anything, anywhere from 192.168.1.1 all the way to 192.168.254.1. You wanna avoid 8.1, and since I'm using this T-Mobile router that gives a 12.1, I'm gonna avoid that as well. But 10.1 is in the clear, so we're gonna use that, and I'm gonna click apply. When I click apply, that reconfigures the LAN IP address of the Slate AX, but everything should automatically reconnect after a couple minutes or so. Of course, you can always force that by bringing up a command prompt and doing an ipconfig/release and then an ipconfig/renew. But as I was saying that, it has already popped up with the 192.168.10.1 redirect. So it automatically redirected to the new router interface on the new subnet that I gave it. Okay, so let's log back in. And we're gonna do pretty much the same stuff. Let's go set up our wireless. So we're gonna modify the 5 GHz. I'm gonna call this Slate AX 5G, apply. And then we're gonna modify the 2.4 gigahertz. I'm gonna call it Slate AX 2G and apply. Oh, I forgot to change the password on both of those. I'm gonna go back and change the password to something strong and secure for those wireless networks. Let's also go ahead and set up AdGuard Home on this device. We're gonna enable it and use it for our clients and click apply. There we go. And the last thing we need to do is set up our WireGuard VPN client. So remember, we generated the client config file on the Flint 2. We downloaded it to my laptop. I'm now going to upload that config file to the WireGuard client section of the Slate AX. So VPN, VPN dashboard under WireGuard client, we're gonna say set up now. We're gonna say add manually. And then we are going to select the file that I downloaded from the Flint 2. Now, of course, I'm working on the same laptop. You can also just email that file to yourself or email it to someone else that needs to connect in. It'll work the same way. Okay, there we go. I have downloaded that configuration file to the WireGuard client settings of this device. We're gonna say apply. And then we just wanna say start. And boom, so the light turned green. That means our VPN connection is established from my laptop wired into the GL.iNet Slate AX, VPN'd through T-Mobile home internet, through Comcast Business to the Flint 2 WireGuard server. Set up and done just like that. Now let's test it out. So here we can see I have browsed to 192.168.8.243 on port 3000. That is the open speed test server running on the Mac Mini. So again, through the VPN from the Slate AX to the Flint 2 to the LAN of the Flint 2 open speed test. Let's go ahead and say start. Now I'm not expecting to get any sort of super awesome speeds here considering I'm going through the upload of the T-Mobile home internet connection, but you can see that it is actually working. And we ended up with about 40 down by 40 up. So that is perfectly fine, especially if this was a hotel room. I'd be over the moon with 40 megabits by 40 megabits. All right, one last thing that we're gonna do just to make our life a little bit easier on the Slate AX, there's a little toggle switch right here on the side, and you can configure what that toggle switch does. In our case, I'm gonna set the toggle switch to be our WireGuard VPN client connection. So when I turn it on, it's just gonna automatically fire up that WireGuard client and connect to the Flint 2 that is in my home network. All right, so to do that, we're gonna go to System, Toggle Button Settings, and right now you can see it's not set. We're gonna say WireGuard client on off and hit apply. And now let's go back to the VPN dashboard here. And if it's right now it's off, but the VPN client is on. So I'm gonna turn it on. I've toggled the button on. It shouldn't change anything here, but when I toggle it off, it should now disconnect my WireGuard VPN. Let's try that, toggle off. And we're disconnected. Let's toggle it back on, toggle on. And now WireGuard has connected once again. So the idea here is bring this to your hotel room, plug in Ethernet if you can, and if you can't, then connect this to the Wi-Fi at the hotel, then flip that switch on and your WireGuard VPN client connects to your WireGuard VPN server at home. You now have full access to the stuff on your LAN. So there you go. It's just that easy to set up a WireGuard client server VPN connection using GL.iNet's routers. Now, if you have any questions about anything that I did here, put those down in the comments below. I'll have a link in the description for all of the products that I featured in today's video. And if you'd like to keep this party going, I have hand-selected a couple of videos on the right here for you to watch next. The top video is my original travel router setup video featuring the Beryl AX. And the bottom video is my review of T-Mobile's 5G home internet service.